Let's have a look at these five hidden neck spotters. This is the spotter number one. Then spotter number two. Spotter number three. Spotter number four. You can pause your video whenever you are having a doubt. So let us see what are all these spotters. Guys, in the first case, we can see that there is some avidly enhancing lesion in the nasal cavity, and this is extending through the pterygomaxillary fissure into the infratemporal fossa, as well as it is causing indenting the posterolateral wall of the right maxillary sinus. Can you think of any lesion that is centered in the sphenopalatine foramen, extending through the pterygomaxillary fissure into the infratemporal fossa and indenting your posterior wall of the maxillary sinus? This is which is known as your Hallmann-Miller sign. So guys, this is a case of juvenile nasoangiofibroma. Juvenile nasoangiofibroma, right? Coming to the second image, here I will ask you, what are these normal structures? This is your mandible. So there are two muscles that are lying on either side of the mandible. The lateral one is masseter, and the medial one is medial pterygoid muscle. Here you can see that this was a case of bilateral enlarged tonsils seen in a patient with tonsillitis. This is your common carotid artery, internal jugular vein. These are your parotid glands. This is your sternocleidomastoid muscle, a retromandibular vein. And this is your tongue. Right? These are few normal structures that you can see within the neck. Here again, this is another NCCT image of the neck. You can see that there is some hyperdense structure that is lying just behind the larynx. So just behind the larynx, you have your esophagus. And within this esophagus, this hyperdense structure, it is most likely a foreign body. Okay, and this was your fish bone. Moving on to the fourth case, you can see that your tonsils are enlarged in this patient. This was a case of goiter. Last image. Here we can see that this is your submandibular gland. The right submandibular gland is enhancing a lot, and also we can see that there is some hyperdense calculus seen within this submandibular duct that is causing dilatation of this duct. So this was a case of sialolithiasis with sialadenitis, right? So guys, I take a lot of lectures, a lot of spotters on Unacademy, like the session that I have just conducted. So on Unacademy, I take longer sessions of 1 hour. And you know, you can join these sessions, which are available on the Unacademy Learning app. You can download the Unacademy Learning app. You can use my code HimanshuMamC to unlock my free classes and enjoy these interesting learning sessions, interesting spotter sessions. That will be helpful not only for clearing the NEET PG exam, but it would be helpful for radiology residents as well as to become better doctors. So do join me in my live classes, and if you like these videos, do give me a thumbs up and do share it with your friends. So thank you guys. Bye bye. Take care.